In this video, we'll be discussing two different methods of finding the expected value of a frequency distribution using Google Sheets. So let's get started.
All right, so we're going to go over a probability distribution and finding the expected value of this distribution. So here is an example where we have the probabilities and the scores. Now you may see it also with the scores in the first column and the probabilities in the second column, but it's still the same exact process. It doesn't matter. And so I'm going to show you the long way first. There's two different ways. The long way first, and then there's a really quick way using a certain function in here. The long way kind of shows you the entire process if you were to do this by hand, if you weren't using Google Sheets. But so anyways, here we go. So what you want to do is you want to do to multiply the first column by the second column, and I'll show you what I mean by that. So this is the probability, and we're going to multiply that by the scores. So that's equal to 0.5, the probability of the first value, by its score. So what this first row is telling us is, so the probability of getting a score of 2 is 0.5, like a 50% chance of getting a score of 2. So we're going to multiply the score by its respective probability. And then we're going to do the same thing in each row. And after you're done with the first row, after you hit enter, and you, if you want to just click back in the cell, there's this little square down here. You click on that and hold down and drag down. It'll copy down the formula. But if you don't want to use that little shortcut, it's good to know that tool. It's really useful. I would really encourage you to do that, but you could individually type them in. As you can see, this is just A3, A3 times B3, and then you'll A4 times B4 and so forth. And then after you find each of those products, we're going to sum this entire column. So that is the expected value. The expected value of this distribution, this probability distribution, is 6.15. So what that is saying, as out of all these scores with the respective probabilities for each score, the what we would expect with this information is that on average we would have a score of 6.15. So out of all these scores with these probabilities, we would expect an average of 6.15. Okay, so here is another method of the expected value. So let's just copy, paste that down there. And what you can do is you can do equals sum and then product. We want the sum product. And array one, array two. And so what we want is array one is the probability, comma, and then array two is the second column. Just the values. 6.15. So there's the fast way of doing it. But as you can see, this is the formula for expected value. When you have a probability distribution, you multiply by the probabilities by each score, and then you add up the, all of those products. All right, let me know if you have any concerns.